wanted to say that the purpose of this breakfast is primarily a ritual toward thinking about your journey through MBA and obviously your senior year, since this is titled 100 Days Till Graduation. We expect this morning just to be a nice time to be together. There's really no formal agenda except a few announcements to remind you of things coming up. Before I make those announcements, I thought I'd mention that I was up early with my wife watching Mr. Kelly's mother's funeral. It was streamed. And for those of you going to Ireland this summer, be a really nice thing to celebrate his mom with him when you're there. She lived to be 95, and there are five children, and he was given the opportunity to speak the eulogy this morning. And he talked about how his dad died when his dad was 43, and that left his mother with five children, all under 10. She worked in a hotel, and she raised all the children by herself, and it's a remarkable story. And he told the story, which is one of my favorite MBA stories. I got to know his mom, and I'd asked him to speak at the mother-son breakfast one year, and he told these stories about his mother and how she kind of dealt with these rascals, all young kids, and raised them by herself, and how he never really told her how much he appreciated her. And when he finished, I got up and I said, "Well, Michael, you don't know this, but your mom's here." I flew her over, and it was just a really magical morning, and it obviously made quite a profound impact on her and on him as I said, even having him speak about it this morning at the funeral. Well, couple announcements. First, the father-son dinner is Tuesday, March 8th, which is 2 weeks from yesterday. And I didn't know until yesterday, my English class will tell you this, who the speaker is, because we had signed up Kurt Warner, and he said he was coming, and then he canceled last week. And so I was been frantic since last Wednesday trying to get a speaker. And yesterday during my class, Jim Nance called me, and he has agreed to speak, which should be really fun because he's done so many things in sports and in his life, and he seemed really happy to be here, and so it should be a great night. Now, to highlight that evening, if you would like to speak about your dad, as you know, we've had seniors talk about their dads at the father-son breakfast. Just let me know. Either see me after this breakfast or email me. And then secondly, the mother-son breakfast is on April the 12th, and it's going to be an evening event this year, kind of like the father-son dinner. And Jimmy Allen, who's been a big sensation in the country music world, is going to be the speaker that evening. And if you'd like to speak about your mom, just let me know. I'd rather have you say you want to do it than have me find a number of students to speak, but obviously I can do both. So this morning, now after those quick announcements, Mr. Sawyer first is going to go over some events coming up, and I'll let him do that now.
Morning, guys. As Mr. Joy mentioned, there's no real agenda for today, but the one kind of practical thing we wanted to do with this breakfast for you is just kind of remind you about a few upcoming things. So this is a picture that I thought you all would appreciate seeing. This is from the first day of registration back in August of this year. So a good picture of your class, and it's kind of a good time to remember you all as a class have 100 days sort of remaining together as MBA students. And so that'll be the theme through today, is thinking about how to make the most of your remaining 100 days as a class. So a couple of things I wanted to run you through. You can see up here several important dates that you want to have on your calendar and sort of think about. Several of these are school-wide, but then several of them are just for seniors as well. So Mr. Joy mentioned the father-son dinner. On March 9th is Career Day. Mr. Johnson already talked to you about that one. Prom coming up is obviously your senior prom is a special time. The mother-son dinner. On Thursday, April 19th, we have the 50 days to graduation picnic. That is for both you and your parents, okay? So this event is just for the seniors, but that one is for you and your parents. Remember that May 2nd to May 13th are AP exams and the senior sports breakfast. On May 12th, we're going to have the college t-shirt day. So between now and then, if you can go ahead and make sure you've got a t-shirt for whichever college you've decided to attend. We always let the seniors wear their t-shirt that day and take a picture. It's always a fun day. May 18th is the Leavers Dinner. That's one that some of you may have heard about, but a lot of you probably don't know what it is. And Mr. Joy will send you more information about that. But a really fun event to kind of celebrate your last time together, sort of a final meal together as a class. Of course, regular exams for all students are May 20th. They begin May 20th. So you do want to be paying attention over the next few weeks to the exemption policies for seniors, okay? You have to have an 85 average on the last day of classes, and you have to have a teacher's recommendation. We always have a senior movie day towards the end during exam time where the seniors get to go to a movie together, and so that's always a fun time. And then graduation week. Make sure you've got these on your calendar that you sort of know about them. So Tuesday before graduation, and that'll be May 31st, we have graduation rehearsal, and then we have a mother-son luncheon after that. June 1 is Honors Night. Make sure you arrive on time and are ready to go for that. And then Thursday, June 2nd is graduation. And then after graduation is project graduation. So all those dates we're going to send back out to you, but they are pretty important to make sure you know several big events coming up in the next few days. And the next thing I wanted to help you think about is today is 100 days to graduation. Some years this breakfast falls 101 days before, some years it's 99 days before, you know, it's plus or minus a little bit depending on when we can schedule. But today is actually 100 days until graduation. So your graduation is June 2nd, that's 100 days from now. In some ways 100 days feels like a long time from now, but in some ways it doesn't. 104 days ago was the Veterans Day ceremony. Several of you spoke at that, Rowan and several others. That doesn't seem that long ago. 103 days ago, our football team defeated Baylor 35-0 in the quarterfinals. I know you all remember that night well. 101 days ago, the FCA retreat ended, and you all drove slowly back home from Long Mountain, right, Connor? Slowly through Long Mountain. The fall music concert and the Titans defeated the Saints 23-21 101 days ago. 100 days ago, Mr. Joe Hodgson spoke at Assembly about Long Mountain and the Trail of Tears. So probably several of those events you remember quite clearly, right? Several of those things you have vivid memories of. And that's a reminder to you that in some ways 100 days feels like a long time, and in other ways it doesn't feel like that long at all. So I want to encourage you to make the most of your final 100 days as MBA students. Enjoy your time together. Individually, do the best you can. Let's finish on a strong note. That's all I have, guys. Let's have a great ending to the year.
Thanks, Mr. Sawyer. He'll, as he said, he'll send that out to you so you can put those dates down. I asked Mr. Deutsch to just say hello this morning and sort of remind you that he's enjoyed being the advisor to this class.
Yeah. Hey, man. Morning. I've enjoyed our partnership in MBA and in life. And you guys, the end is in sight. You're still on the bus for 100 more days. Think about the baggage that you're taking with you in a good way, but leave some behind for us, right? The guys left behind, especially the underclassmen. And here, this is a really tough time for parents, especially mom. Why? Okay, you need to tell her every day, Mom, you've done your job. I'm in a good place. It's okay, you can let me go. But give her a kiss and tell her you love her. Dads are better with it, generally. But you know what else you never forget? Alumni are always welcome back on the hill. So, enjoy the rest of your ride. Thanks.
So Jackson is on Zoom. Why don't you say good morning? He can hear us.
Hey. It's a great smile. Ah, you may be off mute now if I'm looking at that lower left. Yeah, you can hear me, Jackson? That smile says he can hear me.
Yeah, I can hear you.
All right. Anything you'd like to say to us this morning?
Nah, I'll be on soon. Yeah. There you go. I'll ride your car. Thank you.
Well, we miss you, Jackson, and we wanted to make sure that
I know. I miss being there.
Yes, you do. And then you guys want to come on up here and say hello?
Yeah.
Here comes Jim.
Chuma.
What's up, Jackson? Love you, man.
Whoa, my God. I miss you, bro.
You too, man. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good.
Anybody else want to come up?
That's good.
Well, I thought it would just be really the right thing to have Jackson as part of this breakfast this morning, so I called his mom last week and asked if we could do this. You know, Jack, I think we could probably just have Jackson stay on the line and continue this. What do you guys think? That's the best way to do it? Okay, we'll just... Okay, hold on, let me tell him. So Jackson, we're going to continue with the breakfast and just let you see and hear what we're going to do. So I'll follow up with the schedule. So Bradford and Larson, if you'd come up and make some comments at this point.
Since seventh grade, we have thought about this, imagining what it would feel like to be sitting here with only 100 days left in our senior year. 100 days, that's all. 100 more English classes, 100 more breaks, and hardest of all, only 100 more Gates chants. Gents, this is all we have left on the hill. This is the final ride of our NBA career. My charge to y'all is, how do you want to be remembered in these last 100 days? What do you want your legacy to be? The ways we have become closer together as a grade have been amazing to see this year. I've seen people branch out and talk to people who they never have talked to since this year. And in these last 100 days, I challenge you to do this. Keep creating bonds and meeting new people. That is what NBA is all about, the brotherhood we all share with each other. And finally, quote by Eminem, look, if you had one shot or one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted in one moment, would you capture it or just let it slip?
Thank you, Brad, for those words of wisdom. So later you'll hear from a keynote speaker, Mr. Billy Jones. But just real briefly, I wanted to share something that I've been kind of thinking about recently. And that was last night when they asked me to speak, I was kind of thinking of I had a bunch of ideas in my head of what I could say and something that would either be funny or like, you know, whatever. But I really started thinking... It was kind of back to a memory that I had a couple weeks ago. I was at a Super Bowl party with probably 15 or 20 guys in our grade, and I looked around and I remember thinking, oh my gosh, how many of these guys went to Oak Hill with me? And when I started thinking about it, the answer turned out to be like two, maybe three. Because right now we're thinking about colleges, like, you know, who am I going to college with? Who are these people that I'm going to meet that are going to be in college with me? You know, we're looking forward, but I think it's crazy to look back to the last schools that we were at. Because when you think about it, NBA really is a melting pot. You know, we've got guys from Innsworth, we've got guys from Harding, we've got guys from Oak Hill. It's crazy to think that all these schools have come together and now we're just most of a family, in many ways, our own family. And I also, just looking forward, like, I was with my older brother Evans the other day. He's in college right now, and he's got tons of friends that he wanted to introduce me to. But when we went back to his house, one of his roommates is actually an MBA student who's my cousin, Ben Evans. And it was crazy to see that those two guys have remained, and Coach DeWitt knows Ben, those guys have remained such good friends. So really, I just encourage you, just harping off what Brad said, get to know guys in your NBA family that you don't already know. I can't stress that enough. We got 100 days left. Let's end it out well, boys.
We usually have a little music, and Paul's going to play now. So if you'd come up, Paul, and then following Paul, Braden and Jack.
Hey guys, so a couple months ago, I think back in November, I was given the chance to talk at the junior ring ceremony, and to be honest, I wasn't really feeling it back then, but you know, I wrote my speech, and since then, since I talked about it, I've really come to like reflect on what I talked about, and kind of see how it relates to our class as well. So the main thing I talked about was just using our time intentionally, which I know is kind of cliche, like you hear it a lot. But it's really something, if you take the moment to consider, it can be really valuable. So kind of like what Larson said and what Brad said, you know, take this time to get to know the guys that you might not know, to do the things you might not have done yet. You know, I was just thinking about how I've never been to a crew regatta here, which is kind of something I wanted to check out. So if there's any more of those, I don't know if there are, I might go see what those are like. So like things like that, you know, there's a lot of things going on around here. Kind of take the time to go check those things out, you know, because before you know it, you might not have the chance again. So that was kind of the main theme of what I talked about, just using your time intentionally, and just always remembering from here on out that you can always have the support of the guys around you. Thank you.
Hey, guys. You know, when I think back on our grade, I think something that I'm very proud of is our commitment to service. You know, and specifically the fact that you guys do it out of a genuine love for MBA and the greater Nashville community. So over the next 100 days, I want you guys to just continue that spirit of service, and I think that can take multiple forms. It could be signing up for service projects, but that could also be like after lunch helping pick up the tables so the sophomores who do that don't have to do as much work. That could be, you know, if you're a varsity athlete, staying for the JV game to support the younger guys. So pretty much what I'm saying is for the next 100 days, just try to leave MBA and Nashville, you know, better than you found it. All right, thank you guys.
So one more last music this morning. John, Wesley, and others, if you please come on up. And then Billy Jones, if you'll come up after that. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks very much. Billy, if you'd come on up, but I thought I'd say, in conjunction with Billy's coming to the podium, that as some of the seniors said, trying to do some things these last couple of months would be great and meaningful to you and others, like go to the play this weekend. Obviously, I'm saying that because Billy's involved with the Crucible. And, you know, you think about Bradford, whom I see every morning, and he, you know, felt this interest in working with lacrosse the last couple of years. And, you know, it's great to see somebody just branch out like that and make a connection. I liked what you said about service. I liked what you said about kind of getting to know the underclassmen well. That's one of the best things about advisory, if you haven't thought about that. You know, gives those underclassmen a chance to get to know some seniors. Last thing I want to remind you about, if you want to speak at the father, son, please let me know, or the mother-son. And there are some other events in the spring, the 50-day picnic, there's the mother-son breakfast when we have some seniors speak as well. Join me in welcoming Billy.
All right, guys, I know we're kind of short on time, so I'll try and make this brief. I was asked to speak last week, and one phrase that's kind of been ringing in my ear over that time was, I remember in eighth grade before I came here, someone said to me, are you sure you want to go to MBA? I don't really think it quite fits you. And to be honest, I kind of felt the same way. MBA was my second choice. Many of you might not know that. I was actually trying to go to Hume Fogg, but the lottery didn't end up in my favor. And I'd love to say that I got on campus, I got on the Hill, and all that changed. But to be honest, that really wasn't the case. There was sort of a mindset issue I had when I got here. I kind of thought of MBA as a sort of factory where we'd all get put in and we'd get boxed and shipped out as one and the same product, just getting molded and shifted. But there was an attitude adjustment that came to me in quarantine, and that was to view the world through less of a transactional lens. Before, I had kind of thought to myself, how can I do the most amount of work in the least amount of time? How can I get things done? How can I do this quickly? And that's exactly what online school was. So I asked myself, why was I missing MBA when we were sitting in online school, if that's what MBA was? And so when I came back my junior year, all that changed. I started to realize that MBA wasn't just about getting stuff done and making sure you got into the best college. It was about saying hi in the hallways. It was about going to your teachers and help session. It was about the human interactions that we'd so missed in quarantine. And more than that, it was an opportunity for everything. It was an opportunity to pour your soul into whatever and whichever activities you had. Because MBA offers the most expansive and the greatest opportunities of any school in this state. So, that's where I find myself today, and where I might not be the person I thought I was coming in, I find myself more complete, more motivated, and more committed than I think I thought I'd be in every aspect of what I do here, whether it's theater, whether it's clubs, whether it's academics. And I think that all comes from the spirit that I try to put in, and I think you all put in every day to whatever it is you do. Because all these rules we get so bogged down about, all these policies that irritate us on a day-to-day basis, they're not about every little rule. They're about a more general aura, a more general spirit that the school is trying to create. And I think when you recognize that about MBA, and I think people a lot of times outside don't recognize that, but once you do, it creates a wholly different mindset about the school. So with that, I'd like to charge you, now that we have no more college applications to complete, now that you're trying not to impress everyone, it's going to be very easy to simply slide off into the summer. But I'd like to encourage you, pour your heart into something you've never had the time to do. If you're like Braden, go drive 6 hours and watch a crew regatta in Ohio. If there's an art project that's been brewing and simmering in your head, and you've just never had the time to complete it, go spend hours in the studio cranking that out. You know, whatever it is you want to try, if you want to act in my one act, if you've never tried acting before, please audition next week. I'd love to have you. You know, whatever it is, you're going to have an opportunity here at the senior year. You can use it as an opportunity to go home every day at 3:10 and go watch Netflix. But I think more importantly than that, this school offers the greatest resources of any I've ever seen. And for that, I think you have the opportunity to pour your soul into something and create some lasting memories that you'll look back on in a couple years and be proud you worked hard at something. But not just to get it done. To do it for you, not for someone else. Do I have time for... Yes. All right. So I'd like to read a short... I said I wouldn't become this MBA guy, but here I am reading 19th century poetry at the end of my speech. All right. This one's called To My Brothers by John Keats. I'll end it right here. Small busy flames play through the fresh laid coals, and their faint cracklings o'er our silence creep, like whispers of the household gods that keep a gentle empire o'er fraternal souls. And while for rhymes I search around the poles, your eyes are fixed as in poetic sleep upon the lore so voluble and deep, that I at fall of night our care condoles. This is your birthday, and I rejoice that thus it passes smoothly, quietly. Many such eves of gently whispering noise may we together pass and calmly try. What are this world's true joys, ere the great voice from its fair face shall bid our spirits fly. Thank you for your attention, and good luck the rest of the way. Thank you.
So on behalf of the faculty and staff, I just want to say we are proud to be with you. I enjoyed being with you this morning. I'd like us to say, well, I want to remind you of one thing. Please put your trays up or plates up and remember your ties you got this morning, because you don't want to have to buy one of those. Before you go, let's all say goodbye to Jackson and let him know how glad we are that he was with us this morning. Thank you. Jackson, you're going to be back with us this spring for a number of those events. I look forward to it, and I appreciate your being with us this morning. Have a great day. You guys have a great day as well.
Thank you for being here, being so much to me.